Hello students, this is Ashok Mamtani here. Once again we are now starting the Python language. In the previous chapter we have learned about the some basics of the Python. We learned what is actually the Python language is, how can you install its Python ideally on your computer, and how can you use its simple two modes of programming, that is one script mode and interactive mode. So now we are starting the Python language in this, and we will now in this chapter starting the fundamentals of the Python language. It means what the language is giving us, what are the rules of the languages, what is the syntax of the language, how can we use it in our programming. Basically, you know that Python programming is done for doing various tasks, and just like other programming languages, it is also has the various basic fundamental things. Now when I say that the fundamental things, what I am telling is that, let me tell you the things what I am going to discuss in this chapter. In this chapter I am going to discuss you about that the Python is basically a language. Now language means what? A language is the mode of communication, and a computer language means that we can say that a language which is used to communicate with the computer. Earlier we were using the binary language for using for communicating with the computers. To do any task we have to give the commands to the computers, but computer can take only command when it is the available, when it is ready to see your ready to understand your language. So the computer cannot understand your language, so binary language was used at that time. But nowadays the binary language is not used because we have replaced them with the high level languages. Now what is the high level language? These languages are those languages which are using the English like keywords, and using those English like keywords we are coding, we are making a program, we are creating a source code called, and then this source code is converted into the interpreted and converted into the machine form. So Python is also one such high level language in which you are using the English like keywords in your programming, English like words are used in its coding, and then you are compiling that code or interpreting that code, and then the machine understand that code and execute and performs the task according to the program you have given to it. So just the other languages when you learn, you this Python language is also you have to learn. So just like you have learned English and Hindi languages from the nursery, just similarly you are now learn the Python language. You will have to learn what are the characters involved in the, what are the, how can you write the statements, how can you write the programs in it. In a, whenever you learn a language, say suppose Hindi and English, you learn first its characters. For example, in English you learn ABCD, but here you will in Hindi you will learn ka ka ga. Similarly in Python language also the characters which you are going to use you have to learn. Plus you are learning from sentences, from the characters you start learning words. It means in English from first you learn the characters which you call alphabets, from the alphabets you learn words, from the words, group of words you make sentences, and then group of sentences you make a paragraph, and then a paragraph converted into page, and then pages are converted into the book. Same here also in the programming, you will learn the characters, and then using those characters you will write some simple programming statements, and set of programming statements which are doing some particular task is then known as program, and so on. Using such programs, collection of such programs, you are making a software. So just like any other languages, Python language also has some character set. Let me show you this thing. We are starting with the character set of the Python language. Now what is a character set? It is a bunch of the identifying elements in the programming language. It means those characters, those elements, those symbols which you can use in this programming language. Python character set is also very vast, and you can use all the English alphabets, letters, both capital and small, in your programming. You can all use the digits 0 to 9 for writing the programming codes in the Python. Then you can use the some special symbols, space, plus, minus, slash, brackets, equal to, all these special symbols which you are seeing, you can use them in your programming. So these are the special characters which are allowed. Beside this, void spaces, blank spaces, tab, vertical tab, all other characters are also used, which you will going to learn later on slowly and slowly when you will become familiar with the programming in Python. Now next thing is that the tokens are the also called lexical units of a program. Let me first give you a book definition of a token. Token means individual elements that are identified by the programming language is known as tokens. These are the smallest individual units of the program which help us to write the program. Now in Python we have the five types of tokens, that is the keywords, identifiers, literals, operators and punctuators. Let me first explain you the thing that tokens is, that whenever I am writing a statement in Python, I have to use certain special words, symbols in writing that. For example, if I am writing int a equal to 10, in this what a equal to 10, suppose that a is a one word, equal to is some other word and 10 is some other word. So just like your English, when you write a statement, there are various types of punctuation marks are also used. Similarly, here also the token means you are collection of certain keywords, identifiers, literals, operators and punctuators. Let me explain you these things one by one. What is the keyword or reserved word? Keywords are those also called reserved words because these are the some special words in Python language. These words are defined in the Python interpreter, hence they cannot be used in programming identifiers. Now whenever you use any language, any programming language, there are certain words in that language whose meaning is fixed. You cannot change their meaning. For example, I am showing you certain words of this language, programming language Python. There are certain words in this programming language which I am showing on this screen. These are called keywords or reserved words. These words have a fixed meaning which the compiler interpreter of the Python knows, and we when we write this them in our script or in our code, they will remain as it is. For example, the break statement is for using come out of the some process. Break is stopping some process and coming out of that. So it meaning is fixed and you cannot change it. There are various keywords available. I am showing you on the screen, various keywords are there and you will learn the meaning of these keywords when you become familiar. Today I cannot explain you the meaning of all these keywords because they are used in different contexts. The only thing is that today you will learn their definitions, and after the few days when you start using them these one by one in your programming, you will be able to understand their meaning and what is their use and where they will use. So this is the thing which you can learn by doing only experience and when you getting some knowledge about the Python programming language. Right now you was focused on the thing is that keyword, the definition of the keyword means some programming words which whose meaning is fixed and you cannot change it. Now next is the identifier. Identifier means those, there are certain words in the programming language which are not defined by the function itself. For example, if you are giving want to give to a name to a function, class, variable or a module in your programming, then this is known as identifier or this is known as your programming variables. Okay, for example, in mathematics, if I say you let a and b are the two numbers, let us suppose you take two numbers a and b. Now if here a and b, the words which I am characters I am using is not fixed. Somebody other one who wants to take any other, he can take any other numbers, he can take C and D, P and Q or the names. In so similarly in the Python programming also, when I tell you to take two numbers, you can store their values in the memory. So you need the some locations, and that location names are given by the programmers and they are called the identifiers. So identifiers are the very important words which are created by the programmers. These words cannot be understood by the compiler itself, and their fixed rules we have to follow. Let me show you the certain rules which you have to follow while making the identifier. An identifier is a combination of uppercase letters, lowercase letters, underscore, digits, hence they are created in this way. For example, my class, my underscore variable, these all are the valid identifiers. Second, the first character must be a letter of an identifier. Third is a special character such as underscore, and all these characters cannot be used in giving the writing the words in the programming. And identifier should not have begin with a number. For example, two variable cannot be a valid number. Similarly, the Python is a case sensitive language, so any word which you write in capital letter, you cannot use it in the small letters, and so on. And you cannot use the Python keyword as identifiers. Okay, you can use underscore to separate multiple words in your identifier. So this is all about the identifiers. Some valid identifiers are given on your screen. They are created according to the rules, but some invalid identifiers are there. For example, here we have not used the myRec because in I have used the other special character other than underscore. I can use only underscore. 28DAR is the invalid identifier because it is starting with the 2. That is the, it cannot start with the digit I told you, an identifier. Break is a keyword, so you cannot use it as identifier. Elif is a keyword. False is also, you cannot use. Del is also a keyword. So in this way, we can say that there are identifiers which we cannot use, and some valid identifiers which. Now children, as you have learned the meaning of the identifiers, as I told you that the identifiers are those words in the Python programming, the words which are given by the programmers for their programming purposes. Now the question is that where the Python are giving, the Python programmers are giving the names to the various words. The answer is they are giving the names to the variables. This comes to our thing that what is variable and how can they are used in our programming. Now the variables play a very important role in the programming. Variable is nothing but a named location which is used to store the data used by the programs for processing. This definition is a fundamental definition of the variable which can be used in various programming languages. Let us try to elaborate this meaning and the meaning of this definition and what this definition is saying. You must have heard the variables names in the mathematics, that suppose A and B are the two variables. So where in mathematics, if you call the variables, they are those whose values you are giving. Suppose I say A equal to 10, then there A is a variable and the 10 is its value. Okay. Now if I change the word variable, means the value can change in the variable in mathematics. So some can take the A is equal to 10, somebody can take A equal to 15, and it means the value of a variable can change. Now in programming also, variables are also having a values that can change. But what is the basic meaning of the variables in programming? In programming, I can say that the variables are actually the some, I can show you on a screen, these are the just memory locations whose name is defined by the programmers. You know that the programs are doing the processing of the data. For example, if I want to make a program of the two numbers A and B, so it's a program of sum of two numbers, and I take the two numbers A and B. Now where I can store these values? I can store these values in the memory. Suppose this is the location where I have stored the value 10, and suppose this is the location, another location where I am storing the value B. So these two are the locations A and B which are given by the programmers. Now my program will identify these memory locations with the name A and this location with the name B. These memory locations also have addresses in the memory. Suppose the location, this has address 100, and the this location B has a address 200. So the locations A and B, instead of referred by their addresses, these are the locations which are referred in the programming by the name A and B. Now how can you do this in programming? Let me show you on the Python IDLE. I am going to Python IDLE and then I can show you this thing. This is my Python ideally. If I am taking a equal to 10 here, see. So this is the variable a having a value 10. Means the a can has us to a is a look mem low low. There is a some location where 10 is stored in the memory, and we are accessing that value. That value and that location by the name 10. Okay, now how can I show this value on the screen? There is a command, print command in your Python, and I will write print, and in between I will write a here and press the enter. It will going to show you the 10 and the value of that. So this is how the variables are used in Python programming. You can give the different values to the hyphen. Suppose I want to change this value, I can make it 15. Now if I say print a, then it will going to print the value 15. Okay, you can give the values of different data types to the variables also. For example, the same variable a can be given a value 10.5. now what does this mean? This mean that the location where a is pointing is containing a value 10.5. it means a float value, which is called a numeric value float in the form. Okay, now I will say suppose print a, it will going to print the value of a, which is currently 10.5. similarly, you can store the names of some persons in the variables. We call it in the Python strings. In a short while I will going to discuss all these things also detail, so you will be able to understand. The suppose the name is Amit, so I can store the name of a variable name in a variable a, and if I say the print a, it is going to print the name a in on my screen. So this is how the variables are processed in our programming, and they are playing a very important role. Now with the identifiers, why I am discussing this thing is that because the identifiers are the words which are given by the programmers, and here the word a is introduced by me in the program. Suppose I am writing a equal to 10, then in this a equal to 10 is the name given by me. This word is a is used by me in the Python programming. So identifiers are the used for the variable namings, and their the identifier naming rules are used for the variable naming rules or the variable namings definition rules. Any how can you define the names to the variables? How can you give the locations, the memory locations, a given name? There is some method of naming the names, and that is the variable naming rule which I have discussed earlier in this video. I hope now you have understood the meaning of something, this to the meaning of variable and its meaning, and also the why the identifiers are used and what is the identifier naming rules in Python. I will come to this topic later on also in this chapter, but before that I want to introduce you the these values, that is called the literals. What are the different types of values you can use in Python programming? You have learned that you can use the different types of characters in the Python programming. You learned about the tokens in the programming, that is the what are the keywords, what are the identifiers. Then along with identifier, I have given you a simple definition of the variables, what is the variables in Python programming and how they we can use it. Let me come to this topic again. Now I'm going to the my slide, and I'm going to show you the further what we can learn in the Python values which are we are giving as storing into the variables are known as literals. For example, if I write a equal to 10 in Python programming, in this a is a variable, as I told you, it is a location name using which we are storing some location. Now 10 is a fixed value which can be assigned to any other variable also. We can assign it to b, we can assign it to any other variable. 10 is the value which is the called literal. Now there are such so many literals also in the constant affix values in the Python R. For example, I am showing you the different types of literals which are available in Python is Boolean literals, true and false, which are further of two and true and false type. Numeric values and numeric literals are of three types: integers, float and complex. String, there is a string literals means the collection of characters which is single line or multiple line. and the special character none, and there are certain special collection literals called list, tuple and dictionary. In this different types of literals, we are going to first discuss the different string, numeric and boolean and special literals here in this video. Collection literals are given just a brief introduction because they are not a part of this chapter. We are going to cover them in the coming chapters of your syllabus. I hope now you have understood the meaning of the literal and what is the variable. Because while explaining the literal, I have to use the variables in my programming. That is why I have given you brief introduction of the variables in between. Now I am moving to next is the types of literals. First is string literal. As I told you that the variable can store your names. Now according to the Python, name is a string. How can you define a string? String is nothing but a collection of different types of Python characters. It means those characters which Python can allow. So all the different types of collection of different types of characters is enclosed in single quotes or double quotes or even triple quotes is known as a string. Let me show you the different types of strings on the screen. How can you make the different types of strings in Python and how can you store them in a variable in Python? I am again going to the Python IDLE. Now I told you that variables can store numbers, variable can store strings. Suppose there is a string which is made by you using some characters. Say suppose it is P is a one character, then Y, then R, A, M, I, D. So these are the different characters which you have combined. So here A is a string variable because it is storing a string. Now what is string? String is any collection of characters which is enclosed in single quote, double quote or triple quote. Here pyramid is a collection of characters and it is enclosed in double quotes. So pyramid is a string. If you want to print this value, you can use the print function of the Python and you can see this is printing pyramid. Suppose you want a variable having name. There is a variable name and you can store it a name, suppose Ravi. So you can store it in a Ravi in this way. So Ravi is a string and name is a string variable because name is storing a string value. I hope now you have understood the meaning of the variable and the string variable, the meaning of string variable, and Ravi is a string. You can make different types of strings. For example, if you want to store the vehicle numbers. Vehicle numbers are generally the combinations of the alphabets, some special characters, say hyphen, and the numbers. So that is also a string. For example, if you want to store the bus number. Now the bus number, I can take a variable with name bus number and equal to. Now the bus number is suppose RJ19. So I can write in this way in double quotes RJ19. Here R, J are the characters, 1 and 9 are the digits, and the special character, this hyphen is used also here as in this character. Now space is also a character you can store in it, and then you can write the bus number suppose 4590. So this can be also stored as a string in the Python. Now you want to see this, you can see and go to the and you can print the value of the variable bus number and you can get the string value as this. So you can use the combination of all the characters of the Python in your programming in this way in a string. You can create a strings using the single quotes also. Suppose you want to create a string, say hello, you can store it in a variable A is equal to using single quote. So this hello is also a string. Similarly, you can use the triple quotes also for creating the strings. I will tell you the different purposes of this using the single quotes and the double quotes in this string. I have not put all the these things. Now I have to this. Let me close this and again open this and show you how can we do this. So this is also the different ways using which we can do the programming. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the meaning of the string. Now next is that what are the two types of strings? In Python you can create the two types of strings, single line strings which are created in a single line and enclosed in single and double quotes. For example, A equal to Ram, name equal to hello, NM is the name of the string and in double quotes hello everyone. These are the single type of strings. So far which I was creating here right now on your screen, they all are the single type of strings, single line strings. It means you are giving a string, writing that string in a single line. Can we create a multi-line strings also? Yes, we can create the multi-line strings also in the Python, but for that we have to use the multi-line characters and you use the triple quotes for it. Okay, so I am now showing you the in the coming section how can you create the multi-line strings in the Python also using triple quotes. Again I am going to the Python IDLE. Now I can write a triple quote string here, A is equal to Ram, pressing the enter, then Kumar, and then again triple quotes. See now this is a multi-line string having two lines, and in this way you can create a multi-line string in the Python also. Okay, let me create one more string. I love, and I write here in the next line India, and then I close it. Now you can see that I have created a multi-line string in this way. So the using the triple quotes is that you can create a multi-line string. So basically the single quotes and double quotes are used for creating the strings for single line, and triple quote can also used for single line also as well as for creating the multi-line strings also. Next is in strings we can say that if you want to create the single line strings you can do with the single and double quotes. Okay, and do not end the strings in the same line with will give error. Suppose that if you create a single line string using single and double quotes and do not end the string in the same line, then it will give error. The line means that if the strings are created using single and double, you have to complete those strings in only single line. There is one more way of creating the multi-line strings in Python using double quotes is that by placing the backslash at the end of the line. Okay, in that case Python will not give you an error if you are creating a multi-line string with a double slash. For example, what I am telling you is that if I want to create a string A equal to Ram, Ram is a multi-line string, and I just enter that, this will create an error. But if I put a slash error, then we use a Kumar for this and put the single quotes, even this string is created. Let me tell you on the screen again on the Python IDLE how what I am telling you. I am again going to the IDLE part and showing you this thing. What I am telling you is that you cannot create a multi-line string with the single quotes and double quotes in this way. Suppose I press enter then and do not use this, then this will give me an error as you saw that previously occurred. Okay, so I can use only the double quotes and single quotes for the single line string. But if I want to print the hello and everyone in two lines on the screen, and even if I want to use the double quotes for that, so what I can do is that I can put a backslash here. For example, A, then I write hello, and then put a backslash. Now if I close, then this will work. Otherwise, it would have given error. So this is how my Python is working. Okay, so using the single quotes, double quotes and backslash, you can create the different types of strings in Python. Next is escape characters in Python. Now I am telling you certain special characters. They are also the part of string letters. That is why we are covering these characters here. There are certain non-graphical characters which cannot be displayed on the screen. These are called escape characters. Okay. The special thing about these characters are that they always start with a backslash symbol and they are always followed by some predefined characters. These are called escape sequence again because they are never displayed on the screen as it is. These are the some characters whose original meaning is suppressed, and they are given some special meaning by putting a backslash in front of it. Their main purpose is to decorate the output of your screen. It means they themselves are not displayed on the screen as such, but they produce some effect on the screen which help us to give a better output. They are used with the print function as they can modify the output. Now going to show you some important characters of escape characters of Python language and how can we use them. The first commonly used escape character is slash n, which is also called new line character. It is used to shift the matter present to present on the screen, and after this shift it is that the content is going to print on the next line. Just we press the enter key on the keyboard. Let me show you this thing on the again Python, in the Python IDLE. I am again going to the Python IDLE and showing you all these things. I am just clearing this screen again and showing you how can you do this. Restarting the shell, it means clearing these all. Let me again open the Python IDLE. Okay, now let me show you how can you do this. Suppose I am writing a string A and I am printing hello, and I want to be hello to be printed on the hello and world. Better is that I can show you it in the script mode. How can you create a script mode is that you create a new blank file and here you can type a program and save it. For example, I am writing here A is equal to hello world. Now what will happen is that if I print in this way and save it and print A, you can see that I am getting the output. Let me save this and then run this. For a time being I am saving it in a temporary on my desktop as a temp file. I am saving it. Now world is printing single line. Now I want to print hello and world in the two lines. So how can I do this? You can do this by putting a slash n character in between these two. Now what this slash n do is that it is equal to new line. Whenever I am going to print now hello world, the hello will be printed, then slash one will be the escape sequence character, and what it will do is that it will be and the original meaning of n is suppressed. You do not get the slash n in the output as it will produce is that the next coming after it will be produced on the next line. So world is the next output which is going to be displayed on the next line in the output. This is because of the slash n escape sequence. See here, output is coming on the hello is shown on the first line and then world is showing on the second line. This is the how the escape sequence characters are going to produce their effect in the output. There is one more character called slash n. Now using this slash n character also one can produce a space equal to the half inch and up to 8 characters on the screen. Let me show you how can this be done. Suppose I want to show you hello and world on the same line, but there is should be a space in between them. That is the horizontal space. So I can use slash t here and then again save this changes and then again run this code. I will be able to get a horizontal tab on my space. That is the vertical horizontal space in this between. So this is how you can produce the output escape using the escape sequences. You can produce the different types of outputs required in your program. There are certain other also escape sequences characters which I am going to show you on the screen. Next is that next is the characters are like this. You can use the single quotes. If you want to display the single, you have to write like this: a hello, then slash quotation mark world, then slash again quotation mark and double quotes. It means if you want to print the hello world and world you want to print in single quotes, then you have to use this character in your program, in your string. Similarly, if you want to print the double quotes, you want to display the your quotation strings in double quotes, then you can print this in way using the print. Have you understood the escape characters and the next is the next types of literals in the Python are the numerical literals. These are the literals which are supporting the numerical type of data. In Python we can store the three different types of data, that is integers, that is numbers, float All the decimal numbers with the point decimal point are known as floating numbers in Python, and the mathematics special types of numbers are also their complex numbers, which you are going to study in this year class 11. So only in the science students can understood. So we will not going to complete the complex math numbers in this portion. We will consider only integer and float. Complex numbers are not much in your programming, so it does not makes you much difference. Now the integers. Integer literals are the numerical values without any decimal point. For example, 72, 84, 100, any other. The quantity figure is known as integers. And if we store a value a equal to 72, a equal to 10, it means a will be an integer variable in that case. And 72, 84, these will be the values and literals stored in it. Generally, we create integer variables to store the age, quantity, or sales, etc. When we have the values which can be easy, number of people, number of pens, etc., we use this thing. Now these integers can be positive or negative also. Okay, positive and integer means positive and negative integer means that we can use them for our positive and negative values. For example, I want to store the negative temperature, minus 10 temperature. I can create a variable temp equal to minus 10. Okay, and similarly, I can have a positive value. I can store a in a variable temp is equal to plus 50, etc. But I don't write usually 50 in the writing the integer variables. There is one more thing that they do not have a decimal point. Obviously, integers are without decimal point. So if you try to put a decimal point in between them, it will give you an error. We cannot use a comma separator while writing the integer variables in Python. If I want to write 13,500 in a variable, suppose a salary of an employee, and I create a variable e employee salary, and I want to store a value 50,500. So I will not put a comma, just like after 1000 we put in English. Here you do not allow to put the comma. Okay. So while creating the integer variables and integer literals, do not put the comma anywhere in the writing them. Plus, the Python allows you to represent the integers in the various different ways. That is, the decimal, octal and hexadecimal are the three different ways. But octal and hexadecimal, as you have not learned so far in this chapter video, I am going to cover only the decimal types of integers, which you all are familiar with the decimal number system. So we will use only the decimal types of integers in this. However, you put by putting the 0 in any number and putting the 0x in front of any octal number and hexadecimal number, you can represent octal literals and hexadecimal literals also. This is the thing which we will going to cover in later on. Next is the floating literals are those numbers which have a decimal value in it. For example, 72, if I write say a is equal to 72, then a is only an integer literal having a literal value 72, integer literal 72. But if I write a is equal to 72.0, then a will be a floating variable and its value will be 72.0 in that. The floating variables also can be positive and negative. They should have also a decimal point, but they should not use the comma separator for writing them. Okay, the Python in the floating variables are represented in two ways. It means you can use the fractional form. For example, if you want to store the value 3.14, so you use the decimal point. If you want to store suppose 0.58, so you are using the decimal point. There is one exponential form which is also called scientific notation of writing the floating numbers in Python. Similarly, if you have a minus after the minus 5, for example, in this, if you have a minus after the 5, it means it is not a multiplication but it is a division. So 186.2 into 10 to the power minus 5. You can store the using the exponential notation also, you can store the floating values. Okay. The advantage of floating numbers is that you can store any numbers between the 1 and 2 also. For example, if you want to store 1.8, 1.26 and 1.96, you can use the integers and floating numbers over there. Normally we use the fractional form of writing the numbers. Exponential form we do not use and do not prefer. But you must have the knowledge about this. Let me show you on the screen the exponential notations. For example, I want to store the a number let me show you on the Python shell. I want to store a number 105.67898. So this is the one of the way I can do this. The second, if I print A, I will get the number as it is. This is the fractional form of storing the floating values. If I want to write this in the exponential form, I can write it 105.7. If I while write, I can write it 1 A equal to 101.05 E. And then I will write plus 2. Now what is the meaning of this print? If I write A here, now it will be 105.2. Okay, so I can store any number in this way also. Let me write any in the number B is equal to 1.05898E plus 03. Now what is that print B? It will be showing you 1058.908. So this is the E plus into E means into 10 to the power 3. 10 to the power 3 means shifting this towards right 3 points. So one shift this dot point is shifted from 1, 2, 3. So point will be coming to after 8 in this way. So this is how you can manage. If you write a negative value after the exponent, it will going to reduce it. For example, if I am writing 1.098 into E means minus 03, it means this point will be shifted right hand side toward left hand side 3 places and you will get an answer .00108. So this is how the decimal numbers can also be stored in the Python. Now next is the Boolean literals. Boolean literals, they are used to represent the two important Python keywords true and false. Note that Python keywords true and false have T and F capital. So while you're writing these keywords, you have to be very careful and you have to write T and F capital while writing these two literals. The Python Boolean literal true is equivalent to 1 and the false is equivalent to 0. That is treated as the true and false. So the literals are playing a very important role in giving the answers of those replies whose answers either yes, yeah, no, and true and false. Let me show you this on a Python ideally. Suppose I am writing here A is equal to B. If I want to check A is greater than B, what will be the answer of this condition? A is greater than B. This A is 10 and B is 15. So the variables A and 10 and I want to compare their values, I will get that answer as true or false. So this is false because A is 10 and B is 15. So A is not greater than B. So I am getting this statement is false. I am getting the answer false. So this false is your Boolean literal. Okay. Similarly, if I write B greater than A, I am getting the answer true. So true is a Boolean literal. You can store this literal value in a variable, suppose R. R is equal to A greater than B. Now R will be a Boolean literal and if you're going to print the value of R, it is going to be true and false. So in this way, the Boolean variables can also be created, and Boolean literals are also used for this. We are going to discuss more about the Boolean literals in the flow of control chapter when we are dealing with the conditions. The next type of literal is your Python literal, that is the keyword literal and the special literal none. Whenever you have a variable but its value have not decided yet and it is not ready to you having some fixed values, then at that time you can assign a none value to it. Okay, means when you have do not have any special value for a variable, you can store it in a variable none. For example, a equal to none and b is equal to a plus 10, if you are writing, then this values will not be used in calculation. It will going to show you error. If you give any value now a to 20, then it will be going to correct it. Let me show you is on the Python ideally after some time. Now with the last type of literals, these are the literals which are used to collect the values which are more than one with a single name. For example, if I want to store the many integers many floating values as a single name, so how can I do this? Because right now we have a variable which can one variable can store one type of value. So how can I manage that a variable can have multiple values in it? Okay, if you think that string is also having a multiple values, so it is also, although it is a collection of characters, but still the string is treated as a single variable or a single name. Okay, so Python gives us three types of different collections known as list, tuple and dictionary. All of them can store the multiple values in them and can either access either all or individual values. List and tuples are also called sequences in Python. Best dictionary is called mapping. In list and dictionary, you have a collection of values one by one in a series. That is why it is called sequence, whereas so the next token is operators. Operators are those special symbols which help us in performing the calculations, and they work upon the data and do some manipulations of the data. For example, plus sign is a operator sign for the operation addition, and it performs the sum of the two numbers. Say suppose I am writing 3 plus 7, then the 3 plus 7 are added and we will get the results. So the operators are those symbols which are used in the Python programming, and they work upon the data which is available in the program, and they manipulate the data according to their work. So Python provides us vast variety of operators in the different categories depending on the work done by them. There are assignment operators, arithmetic operators, relation operators, logical operators, membership operators, and various different types of operators are also there. We are going to in detail cover all these operators in the next chapter, data handling, where the operate each and every operator is given and explained in detail. Right now we will going to discuss only the arithmetic operators and little bit about the relational operators which we are right now we going to use in our programming. Let me show you how the operators can be used, arithmetic operators can be used. These are the signs of the arithmetic operators. First we have a plus sign, minus sign, plus and minus for addition and subtraction. This asterisk sign is for multiplication. This asterisk sign is for multiplication, and this is for division operator. Similarly, we have greater than, less than, greater than, equal to, less than, equal to, and equal to, and not equal operators. Let me show you these operators, how they work in the Python and how can you use these operators. This is the Python ideally, and now we are going to use here. I am declaring a variable a is equal to 10 and b is another variable having a value 15. If I want to add these variables and want to show you their sum in another variable C, I can write in this way in Python, C is equal to A plus B. So the C has got the value of sum of both A and B. So print A will going to show you, print C will going to show you sum of A and B. So here plus, with the help of plus operator, we have added the values of the two variables and we have got the 25 as the answer. Similarly, we can have the multiplication, division and operators. Let me show you how can you perform the multiplication also here in the Python. A star B. Now B star is the operator which is used to multiply these two values. Now if I write print C, and I am getting their multiplication. Similarly, slash is the operator which is used for division, and double slash is also division that is used for the flow division. We will going to learn about these operators more detail in the chapter data handling. Similarly, we have the operators greater than and less than. If I write C is equal to A greater than B, so I will get an answer true and false. If I going to see the value of C, it is either true and false. So in this way you are getting the using the these relational operators greater than less than in your Python programming. Now next is your punctuators. Punctuators are the separators, are the special symbols that help in separating the one part of an element Python program to another. So for example, they are help us to organizing our code well and makes it easier to understand. We generally use put A and B between the two values to show you the punctuators. Or we can use the Python programming, somewhere we use the brackets, curly brackets, somewhere we use the colon. They are just like the punctuators which we add in our English language. They do not do nothing, but they make the language easy to read and easier to understand. So this the same thing here the punctuators in the programming language is doing. For example, let me show you the punctuators, how the punctuators help us in understanding the code much easier. If I write here AB is equal to 10, then it will be treated as a single variable. And if I try to give the values, two values to it, to A and B, then this will be wrong. If I want to give the value to B, in this case, I cannot give the value to the B. I have to change it. And I have to write A comma B. So B here B is a separate comma is a separator which is going to work. Now the in this case 10 and comma 20 is used to give the different values. So A will be given 10 value will be given to A and B. If 20 will be the value given to the B. So this is happened because of the use of punctuators. Similarly, somewhere we use brackets, somewhere we use colons, somewhere we use some other symbols, and they are used in the syntax of the Python programming. So this is how we can use the punctuators in our programs. With this, we have come to an end of the syntax token, and in the next video we are going to so some other parts of this program, how can you start writing the Python programming, and how can you take the simple input and output in your program. Thank you, and if you have any doubt you can ask with your comments either, or you can send the queries to me either through WhatsApp group, or you can send me to my personal WhatsApp. Thank you.